Hello, our lesson for today is solving problems on three sets. Our today's objectives are analyze and solve problems involving three sets. Number two, demonstrate positivity in doing the assigned task for better output. I have here illustrative problem number one. Mel conducted a survey to gather information about the favorite subjects of grade 7 students. 100 students were interviewed and the following came up. 28 like English, 31 like science, 42 like math, 9 like English and science, 10 like English and math, 6 like math and science, and 4 like all three subjects. The question is, how many do not like any of the three subjects? The first thing to do is express first all the data in a Venn diagram and let us assign letter S as science, letter E as English, and M as math. Okay, so the first thing to do is for you to draw three overlapping circles. Bakit overlapping? Because as you can see, there is mentioned here that 9 like English and science, 10 like English and math, and 6 like math and science. Therefore, you need to make three overlapping circles. Okay, so the next thing to consider is the idea or the concept that 4 like all three subjects. Okay, so kung meron tayong information na gusto niya lahat ng tatlong subject na yon, you are going to place it at the intersection of the three subjects, S or science, English, and math, just as shown here on the Venn diagram. Okay, after considering all the three subjects, i-consider naman natin yung tigdadalawa. Let's take for example, this one, math and science. This is the science, this is the math. It says here that there are 6 who likes math and science. Take note that we already have a number 4 early on, no? Dun sa three subjects. So, ang ilalagay mo na lamang dito ay 2 para total of 6. Background information for learners. This activity will cover the topic on solving problems involving three sets. This is quite complicated in relation to the first part where we solve problems with two sets. Let us then discuss each part in detail so you will not get lost. Venn diagram is a must to be able to solve these type of problems. Hence, let us first discuss how to present the data through the diagram. Okay, we can consider another both English and math subject because we are done with this. So we can now consider English and math, for example, 10 like English and math. So since we already have a 4 earlier, no, we only need to add more 6, no? 6 more students. So therefore, 10 pa rin naman yan. 4 plus 6 is equal to 10 who likes English and math, but not science. Okay? So after answering the both math and science, English and math, we are now down to English and science, which is 9. So for the English and science, we already have a 4 earlier, so ang kailangan na lang natin to add is 5. That makes up a total of 9. Okay, so earlier we are done with this, yung tig-to-two, no, tig-to-two, yung both na English math, English science, and math science. Now this time, we will consider yung mga solo. For example, no, 31 like science. We know that 31 yung may gusto ng science, but early on, we already have 5, 4, and 2 already. So, 5 plus 4 plus 2 is equal to 11. We can now subtract 11 from the given 31.
Okay, so 31 minus 11 is equal to 20. Yun naman ngayon yung ilalagay mo dito kasi yun yung magsiserve as students who like science only. Okay? Basta nakalagay dito sa spot na to, siya yung who like science only.
So notice that the shaded circle shows the number who like science, which is 31. Ito yung sakop ng buong nakasirkel na to. Okay? Hence, 20 like science only. And that is 5 plus 4 plus 2 plus 20 is equal to 31. 31 who likes science, which is the given earlier. So, when we add 2 plus 4 is equal to 6, ito yon. 2 plus 4 is equal to 6. These are the students who like science and math. Ito yon. Kasi nasa gitna siya ng science and math. And also, 5 like science and English. 5 like science and English. Ito yon. 5 like science and English only. No? 5 science like English and science only. And we also have, burahin ko muna to para malinis. And we also have 2 students, no, who like science and math but not English. So, sabi dito, 2 who like science and math, ito yon, but not English. Hindi daw to kasama, but not English. So, we have to like understand really what is being asked. 2 like science and math, but not English, but not English. So, okay, we can now consider the last two regions. So, we are done with the first region. So, dito na tayo sa second and sa third region. So, how do we do that? We already have the 5, the 4, and the 6 earlier. So, if we add 5 plus 4 plus 6, it will give us 15. Okay? It will give us 15. But let's take a look at the total number of students for those students who like English. According to here, 28 like English. So if we will subtract 28 minus 15, it will give us 13. Which is, eto na yung ilalagay natin dito. Ibig sabihin netong 13 na to, those are the students who like English only. Okay? Only. Sila yan, yung 30 na yan. When you are being asked how many likes English only. The same thing goes with the math, okay? For math, you are going to consider this circle only. And earlier, we already have the 4, the 2, and the 6, which has a total of 12, okay? But according to the given, those who like mathematics are 42. Alright, so we will now subtract 42 minus 12 and it will give us a 30. Ay, sorry. 30, ang pangit ang sulat ko. 30. So, ito yung nilagay natin dito. So, this means that 30 likes math only. Ito yung salitang math only, yung sa 30 na yan. So, yan lang yung gusto ng may math. Okay, for additional information, I want you to consider the following. For example, if the question is, how many students like English or science? So, English or science, titingin tayo dito sa circle na to at saka sa circle na to. Notice that the answers are this, 20, 2, 4, 5, 13, and 6. Okay? And they are equal to 50. When we say or, no? Lahat ng nasa science, lahat ng nasa English, you have to consider all of them. Next question will be, how many students like science and English. Hamila likes science and English. So for this question, we are now going to consider the word and naman this time and. Sino daw yung may gusto ng science at English? So we are to consider this part, 5 and 4. Yung nasa middle or yung tinatawag na intersection ng science, intersection, English. No? Science, intersection, English is 5 plus 4 is equal to 9. Yun yung may paborito ng pareho, ah, parehong science and English. Third question would be, how many like science or English but not math? May gusto daw siya science and English, pero hindi daw kasama. So, the next thing to consider here is this. How many likes English or math but not science? So, let us consider this part, English or math but not science. Hindi daw to kasali. So, for English or math, we have 13, we have the 6, and we have the 30. Notice na hindi kasama yung 4. Hindi kasama yung 4. Okay? So, only those who like English, no? English and math. English and math, but not science. Hindi kasama si science. So, hindi ito kasali. Okay? So, only this. Okay, this time, let us consider how many like science or math, but not English. So, science or math ang gusto nila, pero hindi kasama si English. So, we will remove this part ng English. You are going to like cross it out. Kumbaga, wag mo siyang titignan, hindi siya kasali. O kaya si shade ko na to para hindi niyo na makita. So tong part na to. So all you need to do is to look at this one, 20, 2 and 30. So all in all, it will give you an answer of 52. If the question is how many like science or math but not English. Okay? So, for the last question is, how many like science or math? Okay? Science or math. So, let's take a look at science or math. So, we will consider everything in here and in here. So, we will consider the 20. Ito yon. The 5, the 2, 4, 6, and 30. So, all in all, when you add them, it will give you a sum of 67, those who like math or science. So, I have here example number 2. Which will also show us solving problems involving 3 sets. According to this, in a recent party, fruit juice, Coke, and tea were served to 100 guests. Take note that there are 3 who drank all 3. Ibig sabihin, inunom niya yung Coke, yung fruit juice, at saka yung tea. 9 drank coffee and tea, 7 drank fruit juice and tea, 10 drank fruit juice and Coke, 42 drank fruit juice, 46 drank Coke, and 33 drank tea. Okay? Earlier, paano nga ba yung ginawa natin? First, we draw 3 circles, no? Overlapping circles for us to make a Venn diagram. Okay? And then we will let's say letter F, no? Letter F, C, and T be our name here. So, we have, let's say, F, C, and letter T for the fruit juice, Coke, and tea. So, first to consider, ano nga yung una nating i-consider dyan sa lahat na yan? Siyempre, ang una nating i-consider yung may tig-tatatlo. Okay? So, tig-tatatlo, which is 3 drank all 3. So, ilalagay natin siya sa pinakagitna. So, we will place it here, 3. And then, the next one will be yung tigda dalawa. Ito yung Coke and tea. So, tignan mo muna yung Coke and tea. So, dito yung 9. So, 9. Pero may nauna ng 3, kaya 6 na lang ang ilalagay mo. Para when you add pa rin, 3 plus 6 equals 9 pa rin siya. So, we are done with this. We are done with this. Next naman is fruit juice and tea. So, fruit juice and tea is 7. So, fruit juice and tea is 7, but we already have a 3 there. So, all we need to do is to put a number 6. Ay, mali pala ako. All we need to do is to put a number, galang, nabura, is to put a number 4. Okay, kasi ito pala siya. Drunk fruit juice and tea. No? So, fruit juice, ito yon, fruit juice and tea. Para maging 7, di ba? Para siya maging 7, ay meron na siyang 3 kanina, lagyan na lang siya ng 4. Next, 10 drank fruit juice and Coke. Fruit juice and Coke. So, we have a 10, pero meron na tayong 3 dito. So, ilalagay na lang natin ay, ano? 7. Okay, so 7 plus 3 equals 10. Next, pupunta na tayo sa tigso solo. After ng tigda dalawa, ito yung both. Dito na tayo sa solo. Tigso solo. Okay? How many drank fruit juice? Fruit juice natin yung F. Meron daw tayong 42. But we need to consider this earlier na ginawa na natin na 7 plus 3 is 10 plus 4 is 14. Kaya 42 minus 14 is equal to 12 to, and then this one will become 3 na lang. Kaya 12 minus 4 is 8, 3 minus 1 is 28. So, ito na yung ilalagay natin sa fruit juice only. Ito yung only na sinasabi, yung 28. Next to consider is the Coke. For the Coke, we have 46. 46 who drank the Coke, pero meron na tayo kaninang 7 plus 3 plus 6, which is 16. Kaya 46 minus 16 will give us a 30. So, 30. Okay? And then, for the 3 naman, T is 33. So, meron na tayo kaninang 4 plus 3 is 7 plus 3, plus 6 is 13. So, minus 13 will give us a 20. Alright? So, ilalagay natin dito yung 20. Yan. There you go. So, pag ang tanong, how many drank tea but not Coke? Ang gulo na ng sulat ko, no? How many drank tea, ito yon, but not Coke? Pero hindi kasali yung Coke. So, ito yung tea. Pero dapat daw, hindi kasama yung Coke. Ito, hindi daw yung kasama. So, ilalagay mo lang dyan, 20 at saka plus 4 is equal to 24. Now, next question is, how many drank fruit juice or Coke? Titignan natin yung fruit juice or Coke. Ilan daw ang nag-drink ng fruit juice or Coke? So, pag sinabing or, lahat-lahat yan kasama. Pwedeng fruit juice, pwedeng Coke. Kaya ang mangyayari ay 28 plus 4 plus 3 plus 7. No? Yun yung fruit juice natin kanina na 42. So, 42 plus yung natitira na lang natin sa Coke. Ito, sa Coke. Pero hindi na katukasalay yung 7 and 3 kasi nabanggit na natin yung kanina. So, 30 plus 6 na lang. So, 30 plus 6. So, it will give us 78. Next will be, how many drank tea and fruit juice but not Coke? Gulo na ng sulat ko, no? How many drank tea? Ito yung tea and fruit juice, but not Coke. Hindi kasama yung circle ng Coke. So, imaginein mo na yan, kung hindi kasama yan, drank tea and but not Coke. So, ang pwede lang natin ilagay as, ay yung 28 plus 4 para sa fruit juice. And dito naman sa tea ay 20 plus 20. At saka 4 sana, kaso nabanggit na yung 4 kanina sa gitna. Kaya it will give you a sum of 48 plus 4, 52. Okay? So, the answer here for number 3 is 52. Ang hirap mag-manipulate ng sulat. Okay, next. Question number 4. How many drank tea or Coke or fruit juice? Ang dami naman yan. How many drank tea or Coke or fruit juice? So, lahat ng to, nakakasakop na. Lahat na dyan, sasama na natin. So, pwede nating unahin to kanina, yung 42, yung sakop ng fruit juice. Tapos, ito yon. Tapos, sasama na lang natin yung 36 saka 20. Plus 36 saka plus 20. So, ilan na yan? Oh. Ilan yan? Okay. So, ang sagot dito ay magiging 98. Okay? Now, if the question is, how many did not drink any of the three? Yung hindi daw uminom kahit ano dyan. Baka ang gusto niya lang ay tubig. So, we will subtract the 98 kasi yan yung total ng lahat-lahat. 100 minus 98 and it will give us a 2. Ito lang yung bilang ng student na hindi uminom or guest ng hindi uminom ng kahit ano sa tatlo. So, there you go. Ganun lang kadali yung solving problems on precepts. So, once again, you are going to make a Venn diagram, no? With three overlapping circle firsts. And then maglilista na tayo ng ganito. So, hopefully, you were able to get this right. At kapag ganito yung sagot mo, as in saktong-saktong ganito, ibig sabihin, sanay ka na talaga gumawa ng Venn diagram and mag-solve ng problems involving three sets. Congratulations!